Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of the Middle Age Mutant Show. My name is Ty, and as always, I'm joined by my intrepid co-host, Bods. Bods, say hello.
Hello.
We're here to talk about video games because No H ain't here, and that's what we do when No H is gone.
He forbades us.
He is so strict about video games. I never would figure him.
It's that whole motion sickness. Like you mentioned video game, he just starts vomiting.
He's vomiting constantly.
Yeah.
And speaking of vomiting constantly, some people can't take it when you raise the FPS limit on the game. And guess what? Red Dead Redemption did just that. They did a sneaky.
Did they raise it?
They raised it. So, okay, you have the Switch version of the game. You have the PS4 version of the game. But they inserted a sneaky little update, and they raised the FPS for PS5 to 60 frames per second. Which has
so are you saying I need to play this on my PS5?
You need to play this on your PS5, Bods, and this is probably why I'm going to end up buying a PS5 myself, because you can't get this on PC unless Rockstar condescends to give us a flipping Red Dead Redemption PC port, and I can run it at whatever frame rate I damn well please. But they don't. They seem to be like obstinate about that. People would pay for it. I think that people are a little bit pissed about this one costing so much. I think that they were charging like $50, and I agree. That's highway robbery considering how old this game is. You've already done all the work. You think it'd just be like a half price game. Maybe give it to us for like $25, $20, something like that. But that's not how Rockstar rolls.
The thing about this game is they're not doing anything new. So,
no, it's feature complete. The thing that they're saying is, oh, well, we did it because of the intrinsic value of this. That's what it's worth. It also came with Undead Nightmare. So I can't say they like totally screw you over here, but I mean, I see what you're doing, but still.
Yeah.
I would say it's more like a $30 game at this point. It's so old.
Yeah, it's old, and I mean we're playing a PS4 game.
Yeah, especially well, it was a PS3 game whenever it was PS3 when it came out.
Jeez, it was. Wasn't
it was Xbox 360, and I had an Xbox 360, but you could get it on PS3, and I remember that the only other thing that was kind of nice about that is they had like an extra mission or something, if I remember correctly.
So, I probably actually played it on 360 when I think about it. Maybe I did PS3. I can't remember, but
I'm looking at this now, and they actually show official support is for Nintendo Switch, PS4, and Xbox. So what I'm guessing is the PS5 support is backwards compatibility, and they're up in the frame rate just once you play on that platform. That's
interesting.
That's interesting. I mean, I don't know why they just didn't have a PS5 version. I remember
a little bit of like online on that game.
Oh yeah, well, it was fun. This actually had
it was fun.
The Undead Nightmare part is what we played a lot more. It was me, you, and my brother-in-law. Yeah. I remember playing a lot.
I remember.
And we also played. Remember we played a fuckload of Battlefield.
Yeah,
it was tons. And I remember specifically one time when we were playing, and this some random guy started playing with us. And he was a bit of an older guy, and he crashed the helicopter. I remember I just went on a tirade about like, if you can't fly, that guy actually like quit after that. We never saw him again. I really got to control what I say online. This is pretty cool. It's a win for gamers. I mean, 60 FPS is much more fun to play on. That's why I'm going to pick up the PC port of what the heck is the game called? Uncharted. Uncharted 4 is the only one you can get on PC at the moment, and you can play it at whatever frame rate your computer can produce. So
I wouldn't mind you getting a PS5, then you can play some of these other games with me.
Yeah. Well, it might happen because I really would like to have Red Dead Redemption, and I don't really feel like buying an Xbox, if I'm honest. It's because nobody I know has Xbox, so like what would be the point?
No, I'm in the same boat, so the only person who has a Xbox is my brother-in-law, and that's it. All my other friends
Also PCs. Luis has an Xbox, if I'm not mistaken.
I think you got a Series X. You are right.
Yeah, he
plays on PC and then
and Xbox, which I think is kind of redundant because just about everything you can get on Xbox, you can get on PC. So,
yeah.
Anywho, let's move on to the next topic, which is Devil May Cry is getting a anime from Netflix.
That seems pretty fitting, actually.
Yeah, well, apparently, and I'm not going to have audio on here, as you know, apparently the first... There was the end of the Castlevania, I guess, original series, and they had a scene where some guy was walking through this tunnel. I remember it was like kind of like a time tunnel or something like that. And somebody mentioned something connected to Devil May Cry at that time, and that they thought that, oh, well, there's probably going to be a Devil May Cry series. And I thought, well, that's a little bit weird of a stretch, because the Devil Konami owns Castlevania and Capcom owns Devil May Cry. So I was like, well, I don't know if that's really gonna happen or not. But well, here we are, about a year or two later, and a studio called Studio Mir and Adi Shankar are bringing us Devil May Cry, the anime series. And I'm hoping that they err on the side of CD Projekt Red's cyberpunk anime on Netflix, which is called Edge Runners, then they err on the side of Castlevania, because Castlevania to me started off really strong, and it ended like the gay scene between there's kind of like a bisexual scene between Alucard and these two young kids, and I was like, whoa, this is way too much for me.
That was in the game. Do you not remember that?
I was like, whoa, I'm shocked by that. I mean, they weren't kids, they were like 20 something year olds. But I was like, ugh. I was like, I'm a little bit like grossed out by Alucard. I liked Alucard before watching that show, but then after that, I was like, oh, this is pretty creepy. I mean, it's just too much for me. So, Edgerunners, is still, I don't know if you've seen any of Cyberpunk Edgerunners, it's on Netflix. I mean, if you ever want
to. No, I didn't, but did you watch the Witcher prequel one cartoon?
No, I never watched that.
That was really good. It was actually really, really good. And it was similar, you know, kind of animation and stuff like that. Very
well, that's cool.
Anime, but Nightmare of the Wolf. That's what it was called.
Oh, yes. I remember the title, yeah. But I haven't seen it. Well, I'll check that out.
Check it out.
And you need to check out Cyberpunk Edgerunners. And then we need to come back and talk about that one, because just don't watch it when your kid's around, because it is a mature audience anime. And it's
same. I want to say the same for Nightmare of the Wolf.
Nightmare of the Wolf. Okay. And then in this same area of Netflix, next thing I'm going to be talking about is that Tomb Raider is getting a anime as well. Hold on. Let me turn that off. Tomb Raider is getting an anime as well, and that one is by a company called the Legendary Television Production. And this looks like it's going to follow closely with the new iteration of Lara Croft.
Yeah.
Whenever they redid her in, I want to say it was like 2014, 2016 or something like that.
Yeah.
Whenever they gave her the bow and arrow and stuff. So that means that she's going to get covered up. Her boobs are going to be smaller, and she's going to have less bad games, I guess, because I think they didn't get people didn't really dislike this new series until the last iteration of it, the Shadow of the Tomb Raider or whatever it was. Huh. So
I know only thing I've seen about it is that Hayley Atwell, Peggy Carter, is voicing her.
Oh, okay.
So. Well, he's British, so give her a hand.
Yeah, no, that works. I can see that. That's a good cast. I have played very little of the new Tomb Raider, but it looks good. I have all of them. They gave them away on Epic, and I need to just go back and play them. They look like I've seen a couple of people play them on YouTube, and it looks like a great stealth game is what I kind of got out of it.
Yeah,
if you know how to stealth around in that game, it's very possible.
Yeah.
And also the other thing connected to this is they're putting out the new games. They're not new games, it's like kind of remasters. Like, let's see if we can show it here. Tomb Raider Remaster. Yeah, remastered. Okay, so this is coming out pretty soon, yeah. And it's going to have, I think, the first three games, I want to say. The first three games, and they totally...
Okay.
They totally remastered the graphics, and this was, shoot, this is so old. This came out when I was like...
Yeah.
I was in college.
We were in high school. We were like in junior college when this came out.
Yeah, and I saw it on PC is where I first saw it, and then it came to PlayStation later.
I saw Roy playing it on an original PlayStation.
Oh, really? And
yeah. I was like, oh,
I mean, this cool. looks great. I want to go back and play the originals because I haven't.
Yeah.
I only played the first one, so I kind of want to go and play those ones. I know that they diminish in quality as you get longer in the tooth in that series. But and plus, there's much better. We got much better games later. I think Uncharted eclipsed Tomb Raider.
Yeah,
by quite a lot. By the time I just think it was, I don't know. I just think it had more humor and stuff, and that to me that just makes it more fun. For me. I don't know. I like Drake.
He was a cool character.
He was a cool character. He's a fun guy, and it just made me like him more. Lara Croft, I don't know. She seemed kind of a dated character at the time. I don't know if you could say the same in 20 years that you could say the same about Drake from Uncharted. I don't think he's going to feel dated at all. He just was a funny, like, adventurer guy.
It was just kind of like, Indiana Jones or Rick O'Connell. It was just kind of just a fun adventurer, like you said. It was just that kind of, it had that feel to it. And then I haven't really played much of the new Tomb Raider games. James has. They were on like something recently. I guess he was able to get it, or maybe PlayStation Essentials or something, where he's just playing the games. And they look like they're trying to do that. You know, the newer ones, they were trying to grab that feel, like kind of more along the lines of Uncharted.
It's much more serious too. It's like. It's a little too, it reminds me more of like Uncharted 2. Like, you know how you begin Uncharted 2 where you're like kind of basically climbing out of a wrecked train or whatever, and you're all hurt and all that. That's kind of what it feels like in the first Tomb Raider, like, I guess we would call them like newer Tomb Raider games.
Yeah.
Is that they're going for that, like, oh, I'm hurt. But, I know she's like not a killer at first, and then she has to kill the bad guys. She has a big moment of like, oh, I'm so sad. And then she's like horribly murdering everybody after that. It's like her little like problems with killing people is very short lived, but,
well, did you watch the movie? The movie,
the two that I
not too long ago,
the two that not I the, saw were the Jolie Angelina ones.
Jolie.
I didn't see anything.
Those ones are just like, it's Angelina Jolie. The newer one was pretty in line with the game. Wow. I don't really know the story, but I mean, it had the look and everything of the newer ones and stuff. But I don't know if they're making any more of that, but the cartoon will probably be pretty good.
Yeah. Well, all I know is this is coming out, and if you like Tomb Raider, check it out. I probably will check it out because, like I said, the anime's on Netflix haven't been too bad. It seems like only the thing that's been bad is like whenever they try to take an anime and they make them into a live action. And I heard they broke the curse of that whenever they did One Piece.
With One Piece.
Going crazy for One Piece right now.
That I've heard the same thing. And it's from some people I wouldn't even think watch stuff like that. And like, you know, anime and stuff. And they're like, it's really good. And then I remember I sent you the casting picture of them, and I was like, this is what you need to do.
Just do
what's in there. They did really good with the casting in that.
Yeah. So it's coming, people. Check it out. Moving on to the next topic. It's kind of in the same vein, but it's not exactly the same thing. CD Projekt Red is going to be doing a live action project with a company called Anonymous Content Studios. And they said that it's going to be I guess the company's prior credits are True Detective and Mr. Robot. And then They also did The Revenant and Spotlight. I don't know what Spotlight is, but I've seen True Detective and I've seen The Revenant.
Yeah.
So this is going to be the next project that they tackle that's outside of the gaming space. And I don't, you know, it's after Edgerunners, and they actually reference Edgerunners in here. After Edgerunners, I was like, well, more power to them. As long as you can make it as good as Edgerunners was, I think you're going to have, I think you're going to have something good on your hands. I think it was recently where I had heard that the Cyberpunk actually sold more copies than The Witcher.
Impossible.
I found it to be crazy, considering that The Witcher has been sold on so many platforms. But I think that's what I read recently. I might be wrong on that. Don't hold me to that, people. But it would make sense, because if you think about it, like, fantasy versus like the whole GTA scene, GTA sold probably way more copies than Red Dead Redemption, which I think is a crying shame.
Yeah, that is a crime. That's the reason we're not getting anything good.
Red Dead is far better.
It is way better, but all the money goes to GTA.
Yeah, so. They get pack after pack after pack. It's really good content too, like not like BS stuff like they give us on Red Dead.
We're just like, can I have a poncho in a different color, please? <Like that.
laughs> Although I've seen recently, like they're doing more stuff. They just had, if I'm not mistaken, they just had a content drop that they're doing for Halloween.
For real? And are you talking about Dead Online?
Yeah, hold on, let me pull it up right quick. We might
need to jump on there.
Okay,
again.
let me go to
that, when that game was at like the highest of popularity, which was not too long ago, and it did not last very long. It was fun. Like when they would do Halloween events, it was neat. Christmas time, it's snowing in the game. They did things like that. It's neat. It says
Red Dead Halloween in-game event live now ends on November 6th. Oh, so it's already going on. Double rewards on All Hallows Call to Arms, collector bonuses, the return of Halloween Pass 2, and more. Let's talk of the dark forces descending upon the frontier. All Hallows Eve approaches, and with it comes the opportunity to earn bonuses for keeping nefarious entities at bay. Defend local town folk from waves of would-be assailants. I wish they would just do zombies, for the love of God. In All Hallows Call to Arms, with two new maps arriving later this month, and earn rare cursed items in the Halloween Pass Part 2. Meanwhile, Madame Nazar requires the help and skill of collectors to unearth hidden heirlooms and valuables, paying extra to those brave enough to traverse the frontier in these strange times. Once you've tracked down, browse the selection and returning Halloween masks at 25% off before they're gone. Collectors can begin their quest traveling to Madame Nazar's storefront to acquire the collector's badge, 5 gold bars off. Turn in your collector set and get a bonus pay all the way through November 6th. So,
cool. Okay, cool. Well, we maybe need to go do like a live stream or something and check it out.
Yeah, but we can't do it. I can't do a live stream on, I don't have a capture card for doing it on PS4. So I don't know how we would do a live stream of that. I could do a live stream on Red Dead PC online, but I couldn't do it on the PS4.
And we couldn't crossplay on this one, could we?
No, that's the unfortunate thing. You can't
crossplay. That was the thing. Yeah,
I mean, I don't know. Maybe PS5 crossplays, but I don't. I haven't read anything of that.
Well, I mean, for the longest time, they haven't put out any of the Outlaw Passes or Halloween Passes. So.
Have you played this on PS5 yet?
No, I haven't, because there's been nothing new. No new but passes there, or anything.
It is a free upgrade, right? Like, you basically are cross. It's like backwards compatibility. Like, you just pop in.
I'm gonna have to see. Okay. I assume so.
Okay.
But like I said, I haven't done anything. But maybe it's something to check out this weekend.
Yeah.
Because like I said, there hasn't been an Outlaw Pass or anything new. I'm wondering if there is anything new. But you said Halloween Pass, so
yeah,
Halloween there's got to be some new stuff.
You got to spend them gold bars. Yeah.
Dude, I've got so many gold bars. Back in the day, they had it where you would log in every day, do your daily challenges, uh-huh. and you keep your multiplier up.
Yeah, yeah.
And I got so rich off that, and then they stopped it. And they're like, no. Y'all need to spend some real money here.
Yeah, yeah. It was too much. It got too
good.
Too
much.
The money got too good.
But yeah, I will check that out.
Actually, I forgot to switch that over to this. Okay. So here is the last thing that I want to talk about. So this is what I'm going to call broadening Bods' gaming horizons. And it's going to be a part of Snarkade. And I want to know if you want to do this, Bods. I am still livid that you haven't played Hitman yet.
The game you gave me for free in the package
years
still,
ago. Years ago, playing, I gave you that.
Playing, I don't know what the time, I, the Bods, what I've been playing at the time. Bods, probably DC Universe Online.
We'll only play like three games. He plays DC Universe Online, Red Dead. Well, sorry, four. Red Dead Redemption 2's online component. And I guess you did play the campaign.
Mm-hmm. I've beat that game. I can play online.
Witcher 3 mm-hmm. and Fortnite. That's like the only four games that I can get Bods
to play. I get stuck in these. I just don't have a lot of time. So I was like,
he won't start something new because he's so entrenched in these other ones that he feels like it's a waste of time.
Yeah.
Anyways, what I was going to suggest is we do a stream where I play different games that you haven't seen yet and see if I can get you into them. And the first one, like I said, I want to get to see if you'll play Hitman. So I'm going to show you what Hitman's all about, and hopefully I spelled broaden wrong. Holy crap. Geez, this is what happens when you don't have an editor. I'm going to have to fix that in post or just leave it and look like an idiot. I don't care. I would like to try to do this next stream if you are keen.
Okay.
Okay.
I mean, there are new games I do want to play, and I just I would like to play the Baldur's Gate 3. I'd like to play that with you. You know, we have to have the same.
The Baldur's Gate 3. No, I think that's. I don't know. Let's look it up. You know what Baldur's Gate is, right? It's like a.
It's
a turn-based.
It's like D&D.
Yeah, it's turn-based a game. I don't know if you play too many.
Yeah.
Play too many turn-based.
Not too many of them, no.
Okay, let's see. Is there any cross-play compatibility here? So it's on PS5, Steam, GOG. Is Xbox not getting any love? What the heck?
It's not.
Let's see. Digital Deluxe Edition. It says, what platforms is it available on? Is there a multiplayer mode in this game? It says, yes, the game offers a multiplayer mode that focuses on cooperative gameplay. You can team up with your friends and others, friends or other players online and embark on exciting co-op adventures, tackle challenging quests together, and strategize team to overcome formula, blah, blah, blah. Does it have, the question that really is at play here is, does it have cross-play compatibility? The game is currently available on multiple platforms, including PC, PlayStation 5. Oh man, they really didn't give it to Xbox. That's crazy.
Was Baldur's Gate a PlayStation exclusive back in the day?
No, it was a PC exclusive, as far as I know, for the longest time. I don't see anything on the site. Let's see. Does Baldur's, is it apostrophe S? Yeah. Gate support crossplay. Because if that's the case, we can just solve this issue right now. Find out if Baldur's Gate, blah, blah, blah. Baldur's Gate supports crossplay the following platforms: Steam to PC and Mac. Okay, no.
No.
That seems to be the. Let's see if it says here. Well, the game is also available on PS5. Baldur's Gate 3 is cross-platform only across platforms mentioned above. So. Either have to have Steam, Windows, or Mac to be able to cross play it. So I would have to have a PS5. So that's way down the line.
That's it. Gotta buy a PS5.
Yeah, I gotta buy a PS5 apparently. Well, shucks.
Well, that's something I'd be interested in. Maybe it was a Starfield. Maybe.
Starfield. Ooh. Starfield is not a multiplayer game.
Well,
as far as I know.
It should be.
Yeah, shoot. We're gonna have to look at what's available, to be honest, because the thing is like this crossplay stuff has been a little hit and miss with us lately. Remember, we've already talked about this, but Evil Dead was the worst example. I mean, it was available, but it had its problems. I wanted to play Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Shredder's Revenge, but it's only you can only cross play between PS4 and PS5, and you can only cross play between Xbox and PC, and they don't cross. They don't cross. I was like, well, damn it. But anyways. Well, boss.
No.
Then cool. I will. Also here to mention that we're going to be doing a Halloween stream. I don't know if it's going to be exactly on Halloween. I'm pretty sure it's just going to be on the weekend before Halloween because Halloween happens.
It'll be around Halloween, and we will be dressed up. You won't see us.
You won't see us, but we'll be dressed up.
I will have the cheap vampire fangs in. You can understand me.
I was going to say, Boz is going to dress as Jack Burton, and I was going to dress as Lopan. I was like, you know, the antagonist.
Be like, oh, Pork Chop Express.
And I'm going to be all, indeed.
Indeed. You know, old Jack Burton says, the check's in the mail.
We're going to be doing a stream. I won't be playing, and Boz won't be playing. It'll actually be my wife that's going to be doing the playing. We'll just be commenting on it. But it's going to be a game called The Quarry. So I think it's going to be the weekend before, most likely the weekend before, because that's when everybody's going to be celebrating Halloween, basically. The weekend before that Tuesday. So get ready to get scared. Whoa.
Yeah.
Anyways, thanks, boss, for showing up and talking to me, talking games with me. I appreciate it, man.
No problem. Anytime.
We'll see y'all again hopefully next week and later on the Middle-Aged Mutant Show. Bye.
Bye.